This has been The Bizarre Bar with Johnny Midnight. The Bizarre Bar is an exclusive presentation of DZRJ, 810 AM, the voice of the Philippines.
The BBC in London goes direct to the Raja Broadcasting Network, DZRJ, 810 AM, with a live news update.
BBC News with Jonathan Izard. International disarmament teams have begun destroying Syria's chemical weapons and the machinery used to produce them. The location of the initial work has not been disclosed, but the inspectors have indicated that they'll release video of the weapons being destroyed. Jim Muir reports.
This is the second phase of the operation to destroy Syria's chemical arsenal. Officials say it's all going smoothly so far. The first phase involved Damascus providing full details of all its sites and stockpiles. Now the job of actually ending its ability to produce the deadly weapons has started. The international team has begun smashing or disabling the equipment used to mix the chemicals and pour them into rockets or bombs. And they've also started destroying some of the prepared munitions.
The American Secretary of State John Kerry has said that the U.S. Special Forces raids on Libya and Somalia demonstrate Washington's determination to hunt down those responsible for acts of terrorism. Mr. Kerry was speaking in Indonesia, from where Linda Yu reports.
Secretary of State John Kerry speaking here in Bali is the highest ranking U.S. official to comment on two raids by U.S. Special Forces in Africa, one of which resulted in the capture of Anas Alibi, Libyan al-Qaeda leader wanted for U.S. embassy bombings in Kenya and Tanzania 15 years ago. Speaking at the APEC summit, Kerry said that the American view towards terrorists was that, quote, they can run, but they can't hide. One point it does underscore is that the U.S. wants to pivot strategically and economically towards Asia, but it's hard to pull away from unfinished business.
Divers have recovered more bodies from the ship that sank off the Italian island of Lampedusa on Thursday. More than 300 African migrants are feared to have died in the accident. Alan Johnston in Rome is following developments.
The weather's still far from ideal off the little island of Lampedusa. There are stiff winds and a swell is running. But divers have returned to the site of the sunken boat that brought the migrants. It's believed there are many bodies in its hull. And a police spokesman has been reported as saying that 10 were recovered soon after the first dive of the day began. Working on the wreck is not easy. It's in such deep water that each diver can spend only a matter of minutes in and around it before having to start to ascend to the surface again.
The Iranian media say at least 4 people have been arrested for trying to sabotage a nuclear site. The head of Iran's Atomic Energy Organization said the alleged saboteurs had been monitored for some time and were caught red-handed. He did not give any details of their nationality or which site they were planning to sabotage. The announcement comes amid new hopes of resolving Iran's standoff with the West over its nuclear program. But the Iranian foreign minister has now said the previous plan by world powers belongs to history and they must come up with new proposals before talks resume.
You're listening to the news from the BBC.
On the Raja Broadcasting Network, this is DZRJ, 810 AM, the voice of the Philippines. Broadcasting nationwide on 50,000 watts. Real-time news powered by VOA, BBC, and the Philippine Star.
Hi, this is Miguel Belmonte, the president of the Philippine Star. DZRJ and the Philippine Star are enhancing its media partnership to continue serving the community and bringing real-time news all the time. In a fair and balanced manner. I wish DZRJ more successful years to come. Keep your dial tuned to 810 AM. And of course, read the Philippine Star.
Streaming worldwide on www.rjplanet.com. We welcome comments from our listeners, whether it be on issues or our programming. Our phone numbers are 897-8374 and 895-4460. You can also email us your suggestions on our programming. And if you need more info from our life coaches, email us at rjamfeedback@rjplanet.com. DZRJ, 810 AM, the voice of the Philippines, heard nationwide and all over the world via the internet streaming, which can be accessed via rjplanet.com. We repeat, our phone numbers are 897-8374 and 895-4460. Thank you for listening.
you remember the hero of the Ruby Tower disaster in the 1960s? Do you remember the famous anchorman of Raja Patrol before martial law in the 1970s? Do you remember the toning master and his pyramids in the 1980s before our peaceful revolution? Do you remember the pioneer of natural healing and physical immortality in the 90s? Do you remember the ageless broadcaster of all seasons, Dr. Johnny Midnight? Well, Dr. Johnny Midnight is still on the air and at your service over station DZRJ 810 AM nightly.
The views and comments of the hosts and guests are not necessarily those of the station.
DZRJ, 810 AM, the voice of the Philippines, brings you The Midnight Connection with Johnny Midnight. From the weird and wacky to health and wellness. And now, here's your host, Johnny Midnight.
Philippines, a wonderful good evening to all of you, and welcome to the Midnight Connection, where the unexpected is always expected to happen at the most unexpected times. I am your host, Dr. Johnny Midnight, and this is my hour of power over station DZRJ, 810 kHz on your AM band, broadcasting from Makati City, Metro Manila, the voice of the Philippines. I'd like to warn you, friends, this program is habit-forming. Good evening, friends. A wonderful, wonderful, wonderful good evening. Time to yourself is yours. Otherwise, it is something else. Did you hear me? Time to yourself is yours, exclusively yours. Otherwise, it is something else. The something else in life for most people is W-O-R-K, work. Be happy in your work or change your work. You will be happier with yourself and everyone around you. If you do not like what you are doing and feel that you cannot change your work, you are not really trying. There are always ways. Kailangan gamitin po natin ang ating guni-guni. Take steps every day towards finding what is you, what is what you want, what you love to do in life. Search your heart for what you like to do, and then do it without pausing. We all have a spot in the sun or a niche in this world. But a niche does not hunt you. You have to hunt for it. Ikaw ang maghahanap niyan. So try hunting inside yourself. Have you ever noticed that your niche is you? If you cannot find yourself, how will you find your niche? So take time to find you, and you will find your place in the sun. Eh, sino ba maghahanap ng sarili mo? You have ambitions to discover many things. You want to travel, you want to go under the sea, you want to skydive, you want to go up to the mountains, you want to discover so many things. But before you do that, why don't you pay attention to yourself? Yung sarili mo muna ang iyong tuklasin. Because everything depends on you. Katulad po ng aking kaibigan na palipad-lipad kung saan-saan, dala-dala ang kanyang magic carpet. Yan na. See? That is the sound of that magic carpet. Na para bang merong nagpapaihi doon sa bata.
Magic pa.
Good evening.
Hi, John. Good evening. Good evening.
How are you, man?
Of course.
Oh, meron kang pasahero.
Getting handsome
ang
every day.
Ang daming mga pasahero.
Yes. Punong-puno po tayo ngayon dito because I invited some of our lucky pixies to join me in my magic carpet ride. Ang daming pixies nito. Ang daming, oh, tumo, naubo ka tuloy sa pixies ko. We have plenty of pixies here. I invited, of course, those pixies are the, sabi nyo kanina, the workers, di ba?
Yes.
Pero these people around me, lalo na yung kasama ko, yung ating special guest for tonight, is the icon worker, quote unquote. Because when we say worker, at the level of the Midnight Connection, hindi po ito yung nagtatrabaho because of hard work in the negative sense. Hard work in the sense of he or we are doing what we love to do, nag-e-enjoy po tayo, and because of that, ang ating pong mga rewards, yan, is sobra-sobrang apaw. No? Kaya, yan, we are very excited tonight because kasama po natin ngayon ang actually, we na-interview po natin siya, Sir John, way back 2 years ago. No?
Yeah, two years ago.
2 years ago, when we invited our guest for tonight, nagsisimula pa lang siya doon sa ating sinasabing gabi-gabi na dream business. Okay. So, he was just actually, pwede ba natin masabi, nag-start pa lang noon. Mild, okay? Pero, Sir John, grabe.
No, but he took already some steps. Okay? Yes. Positive steps.
Oh, kasi that time, he already earned his first million. That was 2 years ago. Pero ito matindi. After two years, naka 2 million na. Hindi ganun, Sir John, eh. After 2 years, imagine, Deans, makinig po kayo lahat, to all the listeners of the Midnight Connection, after 2 years, 17 to 18 million. Pwede ba yun? Is it possible? Is there, meron ba talagang ganyan na negosyo? Meron ba? Yan. For the sake of the new listeners of the Midnight Connection, yan.
Everything is possible dahil nagsisimula lahat yan sa 1 centavo.
Correct.
Kung walang 1 centavo, di walang 1 million. So if there is already 1 million, then the next millions are already easy.
Yan.
They keep on saying that the first million is hard. I don't think so.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I remember, I did not have a hard time with my first million.
Mm-hmm.
See? So I didn't even know that I was earning millions already.
Ayun,
hindi ko nga alam.
Yan na example ng gawa ka lang ng gawa, nag-enjoy ka. Oh. Kasi byproduct lang yung
pera, byproduct lang.
Ayun. So, pwede na.
Pwede na.
Okay. To all the listeners of the Midnight Connection, we would like to welcome back. After 2 years po, natutuwa talaga ako kasi siya po ang pinaka-icon namin sa group namin nila Sir Johnny, no? Sa The Dream Business. Of course, we cannot, hindi namin pwede masabi. Ang masasabi lang po namin, itong negosyo nito, he is our mentor, not mentor by lecture lang po. Isa po siya sa example ng mentor, doer. He is walking his talk. Resulta naman po yan. Ano?
Good example.
He was a former Globe employee. Ang sumusweldo na po siya dati ng 35 to 40,000 a month. Pero for 5 years, wala pong nangyayari sa kanya. For 40,000, ano? He resigned. Tapos nag-full-time po dito sa Dream Business after a year of doing that business. Noon po, nakabili po siya ng first car niya, Fortuner. And sumunod po noon, after yung mga taon na yon, he acquired his condo unit. Okay? Hindi condo unit na malayo, ah, within the vicinity rin po, malapit rin po sa QC, which is, alam nyo naman po, pag nandun ang mga condo, expensive po yan. And tuloy-tuloy po ang kanyang mga success, no? Kasi meron po dito mga ladders, eh, no? Sunod-sunod po yan until from 2 years ago, again, na 1 million, ngayon po, 17 million. Huwag po tayo mag-alala because yung company po natin, the dream business, nagbabayad po tayo ng buwis. Hindi nakakatakot mag-declare ng ganyan on air. Okay? And right now...
Yung iba, tago ng tago.
Ayan, tago ng tago.
Nagbabayad ng buwis.
Ayan, tayo, pinopost man natin sa Facebook because we are proud na talagang kinita po natin yon and nagbabayad tayo ng buwis. Okay? At ang maganda pong pinaka-latest na maganda rito, Sir John, kaya mas times 10 yung excitement ko ngayon is because two nights ago, this guy, our mentor just bought on spot, Sir John, hindi pinagplanuhan. Ito po example ng financial freedom. Nakita, nagustuhan ang kanyang brand new Jaguar F5. F, ha? F-Type. Alam, si Cluny. Uy, pagdating sa... Okay, F-Type Jaguar.
Bibili ka rin ng ganyan.
Okay, F-Type Jaguar.
2014.
Ayan na, 2014. And, alam nyo kung magkano? Sasabihin ko na po, worth 10.5 million. Okay? So, hindi ko na patatagalin. Again, we would like to welcome back our mentor of the Dream Business. Ha, papalakpak po tayo mga pixies, ha, mga beautiful pixies around me. Mr. Teoh Encallado.
Hi. Good evening. Good evening, Sir Johnny.
Good evening, Teoh. You know, you live up to your name, Teoh. You know what Teoh means?
No, we don't.
What does Teoh remind you of? Teoh, Dios.
Parang deodorant.
Diyos.
Diyo kasi deodorant.
Teoh. Yeah, it means God.
Yes.
Ayun.
Diba? Well, welcome back to the program.
Yes, I'm...
And, tsaka namuti. Namuti ka. No?
Baka namutla lang si Jackie. Hindi,
Hindi lang namuti, kuminis because of our... products. Yan.
Yes.
Yun. Baka kalan lang, babae lang nagpapaputi. Di ba? Everybody can become, have fair complexion if they want to. Di ba? Pag sinabing pwede, pwede.
Actually, Sir John, we were talking about his brand new car. Ano? Ang nakakatuwa rito, yung kanya palang inaay, hindi yung on the spot na binili niya, nakalimutan niya, Sir John, na yun pala nasa kanyang scrapbook or dream board.
Talaga?
Yes. Oh. Yes. That's why yun po isang reason ko, but that's why I invited him for him to share na hindi yan basta dumating na lang, kung di baga nagsimula rin po.
May target.
His goal, his visualization, tapos nandun pa lang yun.
Paubayan natin ka, Teoh, ang magkwento. Yeah. Magkwento ka. I like to hear your success story. I want to listen to inspiring stories.
Yes.
Actually, this is my second time here, pero still kinakabahan talaga.
Pero nagsasalita yan in front of hundreds, thousands. So pagdating dito, ilan lang tayo dito?
Hindi, gamitin mo yung earphone mo para marinig mo sa...
Ayan.
Ayan, pwede kang mag-modulate. This is Teoh.
Kinakabahan talaga ako.
Narinig mo?
Medyo, Sir Johnny.
Okay, medyo? Ano, mahina ba? O ano?
Hindi, malinaw, pero talagang kinakabahan lang.
Hindi bagay.
Kinakabahan talaga ako.
Pulang-pula ang kanyang damit, you know? At least, nagbabaga. Siya? What made you want a Jaguar? Maybe the next one will be a Rolls Royce. Or Maserati.
Actually, Sir John, neto po lang po siya naalala na during my entire year in Globe, more than 6 years ako doon, neto ko lang naalala na lahat ng password ko in all my accounts in Globe, including my email, including my password in online gaming.
Talaga?
Lahat po yun, Jaguar.
Ah, talaga?
Yes. In fact, dun sa isang online game na para siyang Counter-Strike, pero hindi siya talaga Counter-Strike, ang name ko dun, Jaguar.
Okay.
And more than 6 months ago, nakita ko lang siya one time eh. Nakita ko lang siya one time sa isang, sa YouTube, nakita ko siya. So parang sabi ko, panoorin ko nga to, anong meron ba dito sa kotse?
Tignan mo, but that was, when you bought it, there was supposed to be an exposition of Jaguars. Or special sale, or what, presentation.
Mm.
During the, that was Thursday of last week, it was the launching of...
Ayun, yun na nga, yung launching,
yes,
yeah.
Yes, but prior to that, 6 months ago, nakita ko na siya actually sa isang magazine.
Okay.
Sa isang blog actually, sa online. So, parang nakita ko, maganda siya. Unang tingin ko talaga, parang na-in-love na ako, ang kulay nun red.
Okay.
So, doon nag-start, and then, nag-try ako na i-search siya sa YouTube. Yes. And talagang nagustuhan ko yung sounds niya. Una akong na-inlove doon sa sounds. Talagang parang sobrang parang galit na galit yung sounds na parang
brum.
Talagang mas matapang pa dyan.
Okay.
Sir Clu, pero
matapang ba dun?
Oo, talagang every night ang ginawa ko po, Sir John, pinalagay ko po siya sa dyan sa cellphone ko. Yung pinaka cover ko nandoon siya sa laptop ko sa bahay, nandoon din siya.
That was 6 months ago, sir.
Yes,
sir. Okay.
Yes. And every night pinapakinggan ko po talaga yung revolution ng kotse. Every night at saka every morning. Hindi ko alam bakit, basta nag-enjoy po ako doon sa pakikinig po. And nagkataon week before ng launching, nabigyan po ako ng invitation from our president. And sabi ko, it was coincident ba ito na ito yung gusto kong kotse? Tapos bakit, parang tanong ko sa sarili ko, bakit ako nabigyan ng invitation? Na first time naman ako mabigyan.
Uh-huh.
So when I attended the launching, so wala akong intention na to buy during that night. Although, excited ako pumunta kasi I just want to see the car, yung actual talaga.
Display.
Yes.
Manonood lang pala, no?
Yes. And yun, napakabilis po ng pangyayari. Napa-on the spot po eh.
Fantastic, see?
Napa-on the spot
po. Always expect the unexpected good to happen in the most unexpected good times.
Yes. But for me, I believe na malakas po yung talagang attraction na nangyari dahil talagang nung inupuan ko yung kotse, nung nag-rev ako, nirevolution ko siya.
Ganun ang tunog na po.
Perfect. As in, di ba pag may sounds ka, tapos parang compatible siya doon sa narinig ko talaga. Mm-hmm. Nung umupo ako, sabi nung presidente namin, i-rev mo na. So, nirevolution ko siya. As in, perfect talaga, accurate dun sa sounds na
katumbas sa katumbas.
Yes, dun sa pinapakinggan ko every night dun sa YouTube.
Fantastic.
So ganun pala na, Sir John, you can hear pala some of those, yung mga sample ng mga sa YouTube na, no?
Yeah.
Yes,
so
yes.
It's not only visualization.
Remember visualization, vocalization, and then
the
vitalization,
audio.
Paulit-ulit.
Mm-hmm.
And then virtualization na parang nakuha mo na yung iyong hangarin. See, you used the four Vs. You used it.
Ang maganda sa YouTube, visual, nakikita mo.
Mm-hmm.
Dinadrive talaga, ini-explain. So, parang as if ako yung nakasakay. Talagang na-feel ko kasi ini-explain everything eh. Nung nagmamaneho, yung feel niya, everything. So, pinapakinggan ko palagi yun. Tapos yung start, yun yung saglit lang yun eh. Mga 30 seconds lang yun. Pag ni-rib niya talaga parang kinikilabutan ako na nai-inlove ako. Ang ganda sa tenga. So doon po nag-start and hindi ko po alam nangyari na lang po, ang bilis po talaga.
Well, you would not have been able to buy it if you did not have the funds.
Correct.
Yes, yes,
so
exactly.
Apparently you have the funds, yes, even more than the 17.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Diba? Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations. And again, sa lahat ng mga nakikinig, Teoh should be your inspiration.
Yes.
Really. Oh, sa lahat ng mga nasa dream business, ha? And don't forget that on Sundays, we have our support group meetings.
Mm-hmm.
And many of those that are members of the dream business attend our, ano, and yeah, lalo ngayon, lalakas ang loob nila na abutin yung kanilang gustong abutin na tala.
Mm-hmm.
See? Yes. When you wish upon a star, be careful, it will be granted. You may just have another Rolls Royce or a Jaguar, a Maserati or whatever it is that you have. Tanke, pwede rin.
This is VOA News, brought to you live from VOA through DZRJ in Manila.
Iranian officials report arresting four people for trying to sabotage a nuclear plant. The head of Iran's Atomic Energy Organization, Ali Akbar Salehi, told Iranian media that officials monitor the suspects for some time, arresting them before they could do any damage to the nuclear site. The suspects are being interrogated. Salehi did not reveal the plant the suspects had targeted, and it's not clear how long the suspects have been in custody. Israel sees Iran's atomic work as a military threat and has said it will attack Iran's nuclear sites if it does not end its program. Iran has long insisted its nuclear program is peaceful. NATO says four of its service members were killed by enemy forces today during a joint military operation in southern Afghanistan. The International Coalition did not reveal the nationalities of the service members, but various reports say all four were from the United States and were killed by a roadside bomb. Such bombs are one of the top killers of Afghan and foreign soldiers, as well as civilians. The U.S.-led NATO troops are winding down operations as they prepare to withdraw by the end of next year. As a partial U.S. government shutdown nears its sixth day, President Barack Obama and congressional Republicans are trading accusations, restating demands, and moving no closer to a formula for restarting federal operations. VOA's Michael Bowman reports not only do Democrats and Republicans differ on resolving the fiscal impasse, each side appears to believe that standing firm will cause the other to relent, thereby propagating the standoff.
Complicating the dispute is the fact that many Democrats and Republican lawmakers both appear to believe their stance will prevail eventually if they maintain party unity and hold out long enough. What Republicans want is to derail President Obama's signature health care law and to shrink the size of government overall. For now, President Obama and congressional Democrats are speaking with one voice, demanding an extension of government funding at reduced levels previously agreed upon. A few Republican lawmakers in the House and Senate have openly questioned their party's tactics, but Republican divisions have yet to become so pronounced as to force House Speaker John Boehner to allow a vote on a simple bill to fund the government. Michael Bowman, VOA News, the Capitol.
China is on highest alert for the approach of Typhoon Fitau, forecast to hit the country's eastern coast between Sunday night and Monday morning. Authorities have evacuated thousands of vacationers from resorts in several areas. I'm Marty Johnson, VOA News in Washington. More news at voanews.com.
You've been listening to VOA News, brought to you live from VOA through DZRJ in Manila.
We welcome comments from our listeners, whether it be on issues or our programming. Our phone numbers are 897-8374 and 895-4460. You can also email us your suggestions on our programming. And if you need more info from our life coaches, email us at rjamfeedback@rjplanet.com. DZRJ, 810 AM, the voice of the Philippines, heard nationwide and all over the world via the internet streaming, which can be accessed via rjplanet.com. We repeat, our phone numbers are 897-8374 and 895-4460. Thank you for listening.
We
now return to the Midnight Connection on DZRJ, 810 AM, the voice of the Philippines. Here's your host, Johnny Midnight.
And we continue with the Midnight Connection. This is your host, Dr. Johnny Midnight. We have in the studio Cluny Uy, my partner, and our mentor, Teoh. Teoh, who has given us the best inspiration, really. Cluny, you want to ask Teoh more questions?
Yes, Sir John.
Interesado yung mga nakikinig kung paano. Paliwanan mo
na. We've been receiving a lot of text messages here. By the way, you can text us at 0926-615-6537. 0926-615-6537. And here's the first texter. Tinatanong dito, Sir Teoh, dun po ba sa dream business, meron po ba limitations? Sino ang pwedeng mag-join or pumasok sa sinasabing negosyo?
Actually, Sir Clun, everyone is welcome.
Mm-hmm.
So, ibig sabihin, regardless of your background, regardless kung estudyante ka or employed ka or kung meron ka ng business, you're welcome. So, for as long as
yun, willing, as long as, yun, as long as, yun ang bigyan natin ng highlight. Ano ba yung as long as? Yan.
Kasi I believe na lahat po tayo talaga, lahat ng pag may chance o pag may pagkakataon na pwede tayong kumita, magkaroon ng extra income. Meaning if you are employed, mas masarap yung meron kang other income aside from your main income from
dahil the job. Yung mga commodities umaakyat hindi maabot ang sweldo.
Exactly, Sir John. So, mas maganda po, yun nga po yung lagi namin sinasabi, na mas maganda na magdagdag compare sa magbabawas ka.
Correct.
So, by joining this wonderful business, mas maganda po talaga na, I think, for me, napakalaking tulong po nito.
Mm-hmm. Lumapit ka na pa ng konti yan. Yan kunyari, yes. Yan ang ano, sweetheart mo na gusto mong bulungan.
Yes.
Dali, nawala tuloy, tatanong ko si Johnny kasing gulo eh. nawala dali. Di ba? Yung paano ba yan, sir, yung wala pong sinasabing educational background ang kailangan.
Yes.
For an example, di ba, you start, why did you give up Globe? Yung mga iba po hanggang ngayon pumipila, gusto maging empleyado ng Globe, ibang mga communications. Ngayon, why did you give up yung position mo doon na nag-earn ka naman na 35,000 to 40,000 a month para dito sa negosyong ito? Meron po ba kayo, Sir Teoh, na background experience para pasukin to?
Sir Clun, actually, no, sumali ako rito, talagang wala po akong background sa sales, wala akong background in this kind of business. Pero simply lang yung naging batayan ko dahil in my 10 years of being employed, isang bagay po yung na-realize ko doon. Kasi ako yung tao na self-motivated na po talaga.
Okay.
Dahil galing tayo sa isang mahirap na pamilya. So, isang bagay na realize ko doon na kahit gaano mo kasipag, kahit gaano mo katyaga, kahit gaano mo kagaling, if you're employed, pag may boss ka, fixed yung income.
Wala ka na. Yun ang pader mo. Hanggang doon na lang.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So, sabi ko sa sarili ko, parang sayang, parang nalimitahan ko yung sarili ko. So, nung nakita ko tong business na to, hindi ko na po siya talaga pinakawalan. At isa lang sinabi ko sa sarili ko, this is it.
Mm-hmm.
And, kung ang tanong nyo, bakit ko po give up yung Globe, ako, I'm not against employment kasi dyan po ako galing. Mm-hmm. Dyan po tayo nabuhay. Pero what I'm saying is, iniwan ko siya dahil dumating sa point na nung simula ko tong negosyo to, hindi naman kagad ako nag-resign.
Mm-hmm.
Ginawa ko siya as part-time.
Part-time?
Yes, as part-time. So, ibig sabihin, may daytime job ako, yung 8 to 5, that's Globe. After office ko siya ginagawa.
Ayun.
And dumating sa point na nung una, siyempre maliit pa lang kasi wala namang magne-negosyo na automatic talagang kikita ka ng million. pasimula pa konti-konti. Mm-hmm. And then eventually, yung dumating sa point na yung 1 week na part-time job ko or part-time business ko, nilalampasan na yung 1 month na salary ko sa Globe.
Yeah.
So, nag-analyze ako, sabi ko, parang there must be something wrong with what I'm doing right now. Kasi yung part-time ko,
lumaki,
mas malaki, times 2, sa... times 3, times 4, kaysa doon sa 1 month na salary ko.
Times 4 eh, no?
Leo, you have joined the group of those who believe in it's possible. It happened to me, Teo.
Yes.
I was working with San Miguel. I had a very good position. I had very good relationships with everybody. But then when I went back to radio, they offered me 2,000 pesos a month to do a 5-hour broadcast. Huh? I was earning a lot when I was in San Miguel and Soriano. But then I agreed because radio is my passion. Mm. Then little by little, yung radyo ko napunta sa toning, napunta sa pyramid, natural healing. Kaya yung kinikita kong malaki na halaga sa San Miguel, lalo unti-unti-unti lumalaki na yung sideline ko. The start with 2,000 pesos. Imagine, pumayag ako. Sabi niya, pumayag ka, 2,000 pesos. 1,000 pesos for my secretary, 1,000 pesos for my driver at that time, 1979. But yun, katulad na sinabi mo, yung sideline naging, wow, times 10, times 100, times 1,000.
Wow.
Palaki ng palaki.
Yun.
That's eh, bakit, amazing. Bakit di ba ako maniniwala? Naranasan ko eh. And that's why I want to share it. I want our people to do the same thing.
Yes.
Bakit maiiwan ka dyan sa isang sulok na tapos eh, sisi ka na sisi umaga, hapon, gabi? Yo. You're another one who has proven. Cluny is another one that has proven it in his own right.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. See?
Actually, we're doing this no for the sake of the you know, the listeners. Kasama rin po kami dito ni Sir Johnny and kung makikita nyo naman sa Facebook ano, sunod-sunod rin yung aking achievements dito sa dream business na to. It's because I know how to follow yung mga tinuturo po ng mga mentors. Ang maganda po rito kasi, di ba Sir Teo, wala po tayong boss. Palagi natin sinasabi niyan. Okay? Marami po tayo dito business partners, mentors. Yes. We learn from our mentors. They support us. Pero wala, ang ayaw na po natin dito yung may boss ka na kinakabahan. Naku, yes. Kailangan ko pa kasamahan to. Ito ang Diyos ko. Pag hindi umutot yan at hindi ko naamoy, baka bigla akong suspendin. Parang kinakabahan. Yun po, wala po rito.
That will fade away. Will fade away. Look, yung ating support group meeting.
Yes, Sir John.
Yung tinuturo mong release. Mm-hmm. Ito. Sir Johnny, good evening. Thank you. Malugod kong nabayaran ang 188,000 pesos this
wow.
October 2013. I am debt-free. Salamat, salamat,
congratulations.
Salamat. Si Alicia.
Kilala ka namin. Kilala ka namin nila, Sir Teo. Okay.
Congrats.
Ang mga...
Getting better.
Yes. Keep on releasing. If you're wondering ano yung sinasabi naming releasing, every other Sundays po at the Y Museum, we have a method to release, to let go of all the negative programmings na naka-install po sa atin. Example po sa negative programmings na naka-install sa atin, ako ay mahirap. Ako ay sakitin. Ako ay hindi karapat-dapat. Example lang po yan ng mga programmings na if we do not release or let go, it will play back, magiging paulit-ulit po yan. You will remain stuck sa mga experiences po natin. Kaya we have this method every other Sunday at the Wine Museum. All you have to do is attend. Mag-attend po kayo. Ang seminar fee is 500 pesos with merienda. Ngayon, if you're interested about the schedules, we have a Midnight Connection text brigade. All you have to do is text me, dito po ulit, sa 0926 0926-615-6537. 0926-615-6537. And all you have to do is sabihin nyo sa akin, Sir Cluny, my name is Protopio, and please include me in ano. Buti nga hindi Kulapu eh. Paborito ni Sir Janis si Kulapu. Include me in your text brigade. Tapos from time to time, you will be receiving our schedules. Or dun po sa Facebook, we have a new like page. If you're a member of Facebook po, we have a new like page. Dalawa po yan. The Johnny Midnight page and the Midnight Connection page. O, alam na po yan ha, ng mga Facebook users. All you have to do is punta po kayo sa page and like. Makikita nyo rin po yung mga schedules.
Yeah. Teo?
Yes, sir.
Who of those who come for the dream business are more successful? The younger generation or the older generation?
Wala po siya sa ganong... Hindi po natin makakategorize na yung mas bata ay mas successful than the older ones or yung mas older yung naging successful. Hindi po siya yung naging batayan.
Okay.
Kasi for me, ang basis po talaga ng success dito sa dream business na ginagawa po namin is it depends on the person.
Yung kusa ng tao.
Yes. Yung gigil niya, yung kagustuhan niya na makamit niya yung mga pangarap
niya gusto niya. Kung may passion siya.
Yes. You know? Yes. Kasi regardless of the age, pwede kang maging successful for as long as willing ka daanan yung process. Kasi success is a process.
You know, a lot of older people, the elders, no? When they attend seminars like that, many of them say, I know that already. you know, I've done that already. So, with that kind of an attitude, no? They're not inspiring. Pero yung mga bata, yung aking feedback, ha, iba, no? Kayo, nandun na kayo eh. Yung mga taong pumunta ron, decidido na, no?
Yes.
But yung mga nakausap ko na hinihimo kong ano, na
magnegosyo, sumama, magnegosyo.
Yes.
The enthusiasm is for the young people. Mm-hmm. Non-married, ha? The people that have just graduated, people that cannot find a job. Sabi ko, swerte. You cannot find a job, join the dream business.
Yes.
You will have your own company. Is that true?
In some ways, yes, Sir John. Ito kasi yung dream business na to, ano to eh. Para sa akin, mas pabor din to sa mga kabataan actually dahil mas aggressive kasi pag mga bata kasi.
Okay.
So aggressive sila. So and especially kung first time nila, very receptive sila. Unlike the elder ones, medyo pag may alam na kasi, parang pag narinig lang, nakatunog, parang akala nila the same lang din yun. So parang hindi na sila, wala na sila yung tinatawag na good listening attitude. So pag sounds like ganun, parang oops, alam ko na yan, parang so hindi na sila naglo-learn. Unlike the younger ones, medyo although hindi naman lahat, pero there are still mga negative, pero majority medyo receptive yung mga bata and they're very aggressive. That is why a lot of younger ones na naging successful dito sa dream business na to.
Eh, marami nga nagugulat when I say them, you know, it's good that you didn't get a job. Why? You'll become a slave. So, with 30 pesos, you can start your own business. Ha?
Yun.
Yes.
Yun pala.
With 30 pesos, you can start your own business.
Ayan. Tinatanong nila kasi, Sir Teo, wala pa kaming pang kapital. Yan, the usual ano hindrance or question, paano yun? Wala kaming kapital. Anong what can you suggest?
Sa akin kasi yung walang kapital ano yun eh, parang sinabi mo na sa sarili mo na ayaw mo maging successful. Kasi you can always find ways kapag gusto mo yung bagay. Kumbaga pag gusto, sabi nga nila, pag gusto may paraan. Kapag ayaw mo, napakaraming dahilan.
Mm-hmm.
And with this dream business, ang dami pong paraan para makapagsimula.
Mm-hmm.
Sa napakaliit na halaga.
Teoh, people who say that, you know, walang ganun, these are people that are already dead. Mm-hmm. Patay ni sila. Bakit? Mm-hmm. I will go to the cemetery and I will give 1,000,000 pesos per puntod. Okay? Meron kayang mangyayari kung ako ay mag-iwan ng 1,000,000 piso sa bawat kabaong? Walang mangyayari dahil patay, see?
Yes.
So when people say, ah, no, kasi ganun, they're declaring that they're dead already. Mm-hmm. See? Wala na. Sila mismo ang pumapatay sa kanilang maaring mapala. Just, you know, it's so sad.
Majority kasi, sir, dyan, actually, lahat gusto ng success. But the problem is, ayaw nilang daanan yung proseso. Parang ayon, gusto ko yung success, pero gusto ko yung hindi mahirap. Gusto yung madali lang. So,
they don't want to read instructions.
In a way, parang ganun.
Diba? Eh, meron silang biniling appliance, tapos ay basahin yung instructions.
In a way, parang ganun, sir, dyan. Parang gusto nila madali, madali lang yung buhay. Eh, wala namang madali talaga. Kahit saan, mahirap naman po talaga. Lalo na kung ang pag-uusapan, pagyaman. Yun nga lang, dito sa dream business natin, fair yung yung laban.
Patas lang.
Patas talaga. So regardless kung ilang taong ka, anong background mo, it doesn't matter. For as long as sa akin, you are willing to do and to learn the business.
You're willing to take that one step beyond.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. We'll be back after a smile.
Here's your latest headline news update on DZRJ 810 AM, the voice of the Philippines.
The owners of the sunken MV St. Thomas Aquinas and MV Sulpicio Express 7 would have to pay 41.7 million pesos for the damage to 328 hectares of mangroves caused by the collision of the two ships off Lawis Ledge in Cebu last August 16. Department of Environment and Natural Resources Undersecretary for Policy and Planning Demetrio Ignacio said the amount was determined by the DENR Region 7. Senate President Franklin Drilon is facing another complaint before the Office of the Ombudsman. Drilon was charged with plunder, dishonesty, malversation of public funds, and grave misconduct by journalist Manuel Mejorada on Friday. Mejorado was Drilon's former consultant. For DZRJ, 810 AM, the voice of the Philippines, this is Terry Gangquanco.
We welcome comments from our listeners, whether it be on issues or our programming. Our phone numbers are 897-8374 and 895-4460. You can also email us your suggestions on our programming. And if you need more info from our life coaches, email us at rjamfeedback@rjplanet.com. DZRJ, 810 AM, the voice of the Philippines. Heard nationwide and all over the world via the internet streaming, which can be accessed via rjplanet.com. We repeat, our phone numbers are 897-8374 and 895-4460. Thank you for listening. We now return to the Midnight Connection on DZRJ, 810 AM, the voice of the Philippines. Here's your host, Johnny Midnight.
We continue with the unexpected, and we have a special guest today. Well, it's still the day, and after midnight, it'll become tomorrow. Kuno, okay? And his name is Teoh, and Teoh is our mentor, and he has inspiring information for those who are wondering how this person has been able to make his dream come true. Cluny?
Yes, again, for text messages, gusto nyo pong magtanong, 0926-615-6536. 37. Okay.
37, sorry.
Yes. Sir Teo, tatanong po sila, dito po ba sa yung negosyo, hindi ba lahat ng negosyo kailangan mo magbenta?
Hindi ako marunong magbenta. Niya ako eh.
Ayan. What can you say about it?
Sa business na to, actually, Sir Cluny, there are 6 ways to earn.
6 ways to earn?
Yes, 6 ways to earn. So, ibig sabihin, kung hindi mo forte yung pagbebenta, merong other ways.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's for them to know pag bumisita sila sa office.
Ayun. Yes. Okay. So, selling,
hindi siya requirement.
Hindi naman talaga requirement.
Yeah, hindi siya requirement.
Okay. So, all you have to do is attend our free business orientation.
Yes.
Yan. And paano ba ako maka-attend ng free business orientation? All you have to do is, again, text me, Cluny Uy po, at 0926-615-6537. Tell me that you are interested to attend the free business orientation, and I will give you, bibigyan ko po kayo ng mga schedules happening actually every day, ano, nangyayari po to, pero may mga schedules po yan and where at saan po yung a-attendan nyo. If you're interested, again, please indicate your pangalan. O, magpakilala po kayo, kasi po pag walang pangalan, hindi po ako magre-reply.
Okay. Sa mga nagiginig, one must first admit that he does not understand.
Yes, agree.
He does not understand to begin to understand. From the understanding of yourself will come all kinds of understanding, physical, mental, emotional. There are many schools of thought in this planet, but there is no school as complete as the thoughts that you can think yourself. No one can think for you.
Mm-hmm.
Imposible yun na gusto mong ako ang mag-iisip para sa'yo. Your answers in life are in the thoughts that you think. And the greatest learning institution in the world is within your own brain. What do your thoughts teach you? Understanding is difficult in an uncontrolled situation. Kung hindi ka naturuan na mag-control sa sarili mo, no? Palaging pasaway ka, yun, mahirap ang abay. But by getting into silence, you will find your own whiteboard. Mm-hmm. Dati blackboard, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
A whiteboard full of writing is difficult to learn because nothing is clear. Punong-puno ng sulat yung whiteboard. So, anong gagawin natin? Wipe it clear. Kunin mo yung eraser o paper, tissue paper. And little by little, pag inalis mo yung maraming naisulat doon, then it will become clear.
Mm-hmm.
Then you can write what you want.
Yeah.
Yes.
Remember, you are the producer. You are the scriptwriter. You are the actor, you are the director, and you are the spectator of your life.
Yes.
What's showing in Teo's life now? Success, fulfillment, joy, happiness. Yung po ang kanyang movie right now.
Yes.
Now, is that also you're now showing? No. You have the power to change that. Teo is already proof that you can do it.
Yes.
And not only the dream business, anything you want to do, anything you want to do. You want to walk the tightrope? Pwede. You want to be a sexy dancer? Pwede.
Uy, pwede pa pala ako dyan.
My goodness.
By the way, Sir Teo will be traveling next week, no? Where at, sir? Saan po kayo magta-travel?
We'll be traveling to Europe.
Wow, grabe. For ano ba to? Ilan days po tayo dun?
I think for 10 days.
You see? Ganun na. Ganun na. Lifestyle niya.
Sino pong kape sa Paris?
Ayun.
Doon malapit sa Eiffel Tower.
Ayun. Ito ba sir yung travel niyo sa Europe? This is all expenses paid.
Yes sir.
Parang by, incentive
by the company.
Wow. You see? Nakakita ka na ba ng business na may incentive? 'Di ba usually wala? Ang nangyayari po ikaw pa rin expenses mo 'di ba? Pero this ito po aside from his earnings, aside from yung mga nakuha niya, nagbibigay pa po ng incentive yung company. Bakit company? Ano yan? Ibig sabihin, empleyado ka dyan? Hindi po. We are all... We are all negosyante here. Kung hindi nyo maisip kasi, ang alam po ng iba yung traditional eh.
Yes.
You invest, tapos gagawa ka na, ang dami mong overheads. Ito, magandang tanong. Sir Teo, dito sa dream business na to, daily... palagi natin estimate lang daily or monthly ano ang iyong pinaka operation expense mo ayan as a businessman dito sa The Dream Business to gumagastos ka ba sa office yan mga ganyan
actually sir, totally halos zero.
paano yun?
Yung kanyang mga overhead expense, natanong ko kung magkano.
No advertisement.
What?
No, wala. Yes.
Overhead is being
May secretary ka ba, sir?
Wala rin.
May staff ka ba?
Wala rin.
Okay. Meron ka bang warehouse para malagay ng mga stocks?
Wala rin.
Yun, okay. So, kaya nga, I am... calling the attention of all the traditional businessmen.
Pero meron siyang bank account na tanggap.
That's one thing for sure. Yeah.
Kaya nga, we call it the dream business. Kaya, the dream, yung mga iba naman akala, ano yung negosyo niyo puro sa tungkol sa mga dreams? We call it the dream business kasi ito po ang total dream ng mga negosyante. Ang business na walang warehouse, you don't have to put your wares, wala
no
kang
office.
Staff. Oh, ito pa, tanong yes. Sir Teo. During Christmas, ilan ba inibigyan mo ng 13th month pay?
Wala.
Walang empleyado eh.
May ganun bang negosyo?
Meron.
Ito na nga. For three to four years, 17 million net income. Okay.
After taxes yun.
After taxes. Walang, paano ba yun? Totoo ba yan? Yung baka... Johnny Midnight, Cluny, pinaglulokod yung mga kami. Kaya nga,
no
dream.
Way.
Okay. All you have to do is attend our free business orientation. Again, text me, Cluny Uy, at 0926-615-6537.
I will not be surprised one day to receive news that you're one of the top taxpayers of the Philippines.
Yes.
Wow. You know, that's something to look forward to.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine you are one of the citizens who are really contributing to the betterment of the country.
Yes.
Dahil pag top taxpayer ka, ang sakop ng biyayang ginagawa mo hindi masukat sa laki.
Mm-hmm.
All over the islands. Eh? Well, naubusan tayo ng panahon. Let's give all the floor to Teo. Okay, mm-hmm. Teo. Give them your words of wisdom.
Your thoughts.
Una sa lahat, magpapasalamat din po kay Sir Johnny at kay Sir Cluny for inviting me here tonight. Sa lahat po ng mga nakikinig po ngayong gabi, whether estudyante po kayo, empleyado po kayo, or meron po kayong pinagkakabalang negosyo, iniimbitahan po namin kayo dito sa tinatawag po namin Dream Business. Hindi po to yung tinatawag na wala po naman talagang overnight success. Mayroong proseso tayong ginagawa dito. Ang maganda po, whether may alam ka or wala kang alam, it doesn't matter kasi tuturuan namin po kayo. And one thing for sure, kasama po namin si Sir Cluny and Sir Johnny Midnight in this dream business, hindi po namin kayo pababayaan. Sigurado po ako na matututo po tayo rito. So again, thank you very much.
Thank you. Pinaunlakan mo ako. It is my pleasure to have you in the studio.
Yeah. Kinakabahan po ako.
Cluny?
Yes, again, thank you very much. Napaka-busy po nitong taon to. Natutuwa po kami, isang invite lang po, umuo ka agad siya. Hindi pinipilahan po ito. No, pinipilahan po siya para makakuha ng schedules. Pero natutuwa kami dahil napakalakas ng Midnight Connection sa ating mentor. And in life, you have to have many mentors, hindi po sa isa lang. For example, pagdating po dito sa negosyo ng ito, I submit myself to Sir Teoh as my business mentor. In life, alam nyo naman, di ba? Gabi-gabi, naririnig nyo sa akin, I submit my early mentor talaga na hanggang ngayon. In life naman, in general, of course, si Sir Johnny Midnight, no? Because I've been his student since way back 1990s. Naikinig po ako sa Midnight Connections. Nag-start po ako makinig at the age of 13 to 14 years old, no? Kaya in life, again, you have to have many mentors. Hindi pwedeng isa lang. You have to have mentors in business, in health, in life, in relationships. Marami po dapat. Kaya again, thank you Sir Johnny, and thank you Sir Teoh for natutuwa ako sa ganitong, sana mas madalas pa, no? Pag madalas to, ibig sabihin marami po tayong success pa na dadating. Sir Johnny.
Okay, thank you to Cluny and to Teoh. It's been a different night in my life. And again, this is what makes my broadcasting worth doing. Kaya ito yung passion ko. See, this is what I love to do, especially that part of convincing people that you also can do it. Huwag kayong maniniwala na yun lang mga nag-aral. No. Basta marunong kayong bumilang, sumulat, at magbasa, you can be multimillionaires. Okay? Good morning, Philippines. A wonderful good morning to all of you. I love you, and I do care.
This has been the Midnight Connection with Johnny Midnight. The Midnight Connection is an exclusive presentation of DZRJ, 810 AM, the voice of the Philippines.